afternoon. What I'm working on today is just a bit of doodling. I started this last night when everybody was busy watching TV and stuff like that, or they had just come back from school and exams and stuff, so we were just unwinding. So I love doodling. I love relaxing and getting out my paints, and I love doing some doodling. So I started this last night, and I thought I'd show you how easy and relaxing. I've had a lot of comments saying, how do you do it? And there really is no real rules or anything how you do it. So I thought I'd just finish this off and show you how fun it is. I used my Zig Memory Writers from CureTake. I love the color and the richness of it. And to do the watercolors too, I also use, CureTake has these really handy watercolor brushes actually, that you can fill up water, and you can do it to paint, which are really fun to do. Okay, with the doodling, there's no rules. I think the problem that a lot of people have to do with it is that they're worried they're going to make a mistake. I know when I took art at university, I was always so worried that I was going to make a mistake, or you know when you're a kid and your mom's always saying, oh, stay in the lines, you know, don't get out of the lines, you want to stay in those lines. So we're always growing up worrying that we're going to make that mistake. But when you're doodling, have fun, you know. There's no real rhythm to it, there's no real reason what you have to do. I love just letting my mind go and seeing where one line is going to lead to another. See how I just do lines to dots to circles? Years ago, I'm not going to date myself, but a few years ago, a few years ago I worked with Lewis Craft. I don't know if anybody really remembers Lewis Craft. But that was a big chain craft store that they used to have in the 80s. I think there was even in the 90s. There might be some around, I'm not really sure. But I used to work in Lewis Craft. And that was when first started the toll painting. All came out. And I used to love doing... I used to teach classes on toll painting. And do you remember when the toll painting, you would do, like, see the dashes on your wood, the lines, see how I'm doing that? And then you might do a X here if you wanted to separate them. See how it just, when you do that, that's why I'm bringing this up. When you're circling like that with the black, actually I'm using brown here, but when you're doing a dark color with a color, you're popping up your color. It automatically draws your eye to that. And that's the whole theory behind it. Behind using the dark line with a color. Now I could do that with a white. It's what it is, it's two opposite colors. So I could do that with a white. Or I could do it with a navy blue. I just chose it this time because of the browns I have in my color here. I used a Tattered Angels glimmer mist here on it, so I have a lot of browns and like a distressing color here. So I'm using a brown here to just tie it all together nicely. So now I'll use some little stitch lines here. Now if I wanted to add another color here, I really could actually. So if I wanted to bring in, I'm now using, this is CureTakes again, this is their floating brush. This is the scrolling brush. And which is nice, it's a flexible brush to it. And then I can just bring it in. See, just add a little bit of color to it. Which I'm still outlining, I'm still doing a little bit of doodling here, and I'm just adding touches of color. Just kind of fun. this fun too is I went through poetry that I had. I keep lots of old notes and memos from way past. This is actually poetry that I had done. Geesh, I think this is grade 5. Anyway, it's good because if you want to use any of the words or whatever on it, you can. And it just adds, this is when you're tying in your doodling and making it almost like a mixed media piece, which is actually really kind of fun. So I'm going to use the scroll brush here, and I'm going to pick some of the words that I had written. Now I'm telling you again, I think I was about 12 here. So let's say, where am I going to add this here? I'm going to start over here. And now remember, it doesn't have to be perfect, right? Actually, the more whimsical, what I like doing, it's kind of hard with these letters, but when I have other letters, these are all kind of look like capitals and small letters at the same time, but when I have some letters that can look small and capital letters, like mixing up here, I can do with like color. Make it look more whimsical. So colors. So now, I know it doesn't look like much right now. That's the thing. A lot of times when I start things, I think, I don't know if I like that. But then you have to give it a moment, and you have to play with it. I find the more you put layers on things, the more you play with things, you have to give things a chance to grow, kind of like a seed. When you plant that seed, it's just amazing to think that that little seed is going to grow into some big, beautiful, lovely plant, right? So here. Okay, colors. Okay. In. The more lines I have, the better. The more dots I have, the better. So I just mix it up. And you know what else I like? I'll show you right here. I love scribbles. You know, I used to teach, and I used to love when kids would just be as creative and use as many different wild and wonderful colors as possible. See, look at, I'm just, don't be worried of the lines. It's more appealing. Unless you have a piece that you really want to have lines, like some places in here I have just nice, delicate, straight lines, but in these lettering, see how I created that two lines, one line here, one line here, it creates that nice little 3D effect right in here. I can even go like this, create like an illusion of a shadow right there. Just fantastic. I love that. Okay. There, we fill it in with a little. There. There we go. Awesome. Love it, love it, love it. Almost done these. See how fast I can go through these? I'm just going through, just adding some lines. Doing some circles. See, it also matches the splattering from the glimmer mist on the back. Some nice. I would really love if you guys do some doodles, try it out, and send some examples into me. I would love to see what you come up with. I think it's fantastic. So. These pens are super nice for the color and for working on any type of paper. I find even plastics or Mod Podge. I Mod Podge a lot of things, and the color stays nice and vibrant and nice and clean. on it. It doesn't fade, which is really nice. It's important when you spend a lot of time on projects. You don't want your color to fade on you right away. Forever. Okay, there we go. So there we go. That's done. If you want to, it's really nice. You have a thick end on that side. So you have that, and you have that, which is awesome. I tend to use the thin side a little bit more than the thick, but this can work great for dashes. See? You make a nice thick line. Look who's watching you. See? All the way down. I'm sound effects now. My kids would be making fun of me right now. I'm sorry. See, it goes all the way. There. Okay. Actually, I'll use that thick side again. And just do it. Okay. I went onto the thin side again. I just want to finish up this. There are a nice little scribble to complete it. I'm going to do a little bit here, like that. I want it to fill in this side right here. So what I'm going to do, heart, and I just see, and then okay, and because we got this green here, and then there's still a little bit of my chart here, so I'll bring this, and I've got a little bit of space here. I want to keep it kind of the same here. And I know I said scribbles, it doesn't matter with you not scribbling, but doodling. But I want to keep it kind of uniform. So I see? And then see? There we go. Voila. I'm gonna bring it down over here too. Just to fill in the space. Before the time runs out on this, I'm going to use, Caretake also has a squeeze and roll glue, which is really neat to put on some really fine glitter, which I'm going to do now too. So, we'll just put pen it on, and I really think I'm going to make, I don't have my tray with me right now, so you'll have to forgive me. So I'm going to use a card. Okay, we're almost out of time here. I'm using my daughter's camera, so mine's kind of being fixed right now. So let's just quickly finish this up. I'll do one more, two more, and then three more. Okay? And then we'll wrap it up. And we'll have my new camera back, or my old camera fixed. And then we'll see you next time. But see how easy doodling is and how relaxing that was. And I was just chatting, and we made this cute little postcard that we can give to somebody, or you can use it as a mixed media piece, part of a album or a postcard or a layout or a card. And there you go. Colors in the sky. Thanks so much. And we'll see you.